gonna make me cry.
This is Sophie, the newest member of PE Science.
This is who we're podcasting with today.
You might be giving up happiness on either end.
What's going on, guys? Welcome to today's video. It is the first day of FitCon London. I feel like today's video is gonna be a little bit of expo stuff. My main thing is I wanna continue to show you guys what I'm eating and my training session and stuff while I'm traveling, because like this is a lot of estimation and this is a lot of stuff that you guys can use if you're like ever going out to eat or if you're ever trying to stay on track and you like don't have the comfort of your own kitchen and like your own food scale. So what I did this morning, I had one Bite Meals Blondie because I was starving, and I feel like I'm gonna have three bigger meals today and that's probably gonna be it. It's a low carb day, but I am having carbs for breakfast, so I'm having...
So what I got was an egg white omelet. I got no butter, no oil. I got veggies in here, a little bit of bacon, a little bit of cucumber, and then a little bit of fruit for my breakfast. Macros are gonna be on the screen right there. Thank you.
And that's gonna be it for breakfast, and I'll probably, that'll definitely hold me over for like the large majority of the day. Pineapples are my favorite fruit. That's it.
Yes.
Cry. That is amazing.
It just like one does not simply start the day without coffee and Gucci Radio.
That's so amazing. Literally.
Yo.
It's gonna make me cry.
Isabel, she brought us treats from Madrid, which is basically just like a little thin rice cake with yogurt on it. Delicious. Macros on here for 2. 6 fat, 19 carb. It's hard to see because it's in Spanish, but 2 protein or so.
What?
Hey!
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 The genuine reaction was so much better. I can't fake it.
Expo was fun. I didn't take any of my makeup off. Val and I are deadlifting together. She's a little stronger than me, I think.
You're a little stronger than me.
I don't think so, man. After watching you kill your powerlifting meat, I'm pretty
still
sure
stronger.
I'm not.
Dinner time. We have a PE Science team dinner. Oh, Belle has to pee? This is Sophie, the newest member of PE Science. Rob is not a member, but yeah, he's an honorary member.
I'm not here. You didn't see nothing.
So for my next meal, I already tracked this meal in the beginning of the day, and it's bigots or whatever, so I'm just basically getting one sushi roll with tuna, 2 pieces of ahi tuna, and then a salad and soup that essentially has like little to no calories. Probably just gonna not count that. Sushi is something that's really easy to track. I usually just track something similar every time. It's right around like 30, 40 carb, and then like 20, 30 protein. 15 or so. I'm probably going over macros most days of this trip, actually, but my energy expenditure is a lot higher. So we're good.
Emily Duncan ordered an entire plate of tropical fruit.
I didn't know it was going to be here.
We're in London. I thought we were in London, not like Bali.
I'm on like a tropical vacation right now.
And then Valentina got a cheesecake that looks like a towel. It looks like those hand towels that we got.
No, it's not.
Okay. You touch it.
For a second, I thought it was. It's not.
Oh, it's definitely a cheesecake.
And I got no dessert because I'm kidding, but I'm not sad about it because I've eaten much desserts in my time.
This is not a good angle. The best thing about these new podcast headphones is that I can lay in bed and not even like worry about it.
This is who we're podcasting with today.
Yes, it's me.
I'm so excited.
I'm quite worried my hiccups are gonna come back and I'm gonna be like, yeah, my neck is good.
Grace had the hiccup when she walked in and I was like,
oh, they were literally so
we're supposed
loud
to talk too for an hour, but it's fine. The other best thing about podcasting is you don't have to care what you look like. I have lots of questions to ask Grace because she's an awesome person. If you don't follow her on YouTube already, she has a wonderful, wonderful YouTube channel. Like, she's so good at what she does. So we're gonna
thank
podcast.
You.
Oh my god. Yeah. She's like, what?
What is this?
Compliment Central. That's also what the podcast is, so just be prepared just
oh, good
to take it.
I love a good compliment. I can take it.
How do you just see everybody in ones and zeros or live by a code? Or, what is it about punching numbers? That format or whatever. That's a great question. I've never really thought on that. I guess I could talk about how I got into accounting. I knew that I wanted to be in business of some sort, business school. Then I quickly realized, I'm intrigued about how a company makes money. Okay. I want to know, from the top line revenue to the cost of goods sold. It really intrigued me seeing like, okay, and accounting is very controlled.
Two airports I've been in, I've had to walk for like 15 minutes to get to the next gate. I'm in Montreal right now. I have a layover. It's 5 hours long. Perfect timing to get to talk to you guys because I have something to say. We're gonna talk about this video, the title of it, but just let me find a quiet place in the airport.
Not before I stop and eat food, so.
I got tuna tacos. It's high carb day. Spicy mayo on the side, but this is just tuna, cucumber, salad, and like these little flour tortillas or corn tortillas. They're probably flour tortillas and I will track three of them. Yum.
All right guys, we found a good quiet spot in the airport where I can just talk to you guys. I've been meaning to talk to you all about this particular topic for quite some time because I think it's super important to discuss like how strict you really need to be or how strict you really want to be and how not strict you really can and want to be. So we're gonna do this on a scale of 0 to 10. 0 being you don't give any shits, like 0 of them. You give 0 shits about your health, about the amount of food that you're eating, about your macros. You don't care about what you, like you just don't even think about what you put in your mouth, you just eat. That's probably like a bad extreme. So 0 is like an unhealthy, potentially overweight person, someone that might be having a chronic illness or is on their way to have a chronic illness, someone that needs a little bit of help. And then on the other end, number 10 is gonna be someone that's on the other end of the extreme. So someone that might be in contest prep, someone that is to the T tracking their calories, tracks their macros, very gram, maybe tracks their like condiments and like ketchup and they weigh every single thing out and they know exactly the amount of food they're putting into their body. They're hopefully giving their body the right nutrients, but they're very, very, very hyper aware and hyper focused of what they're doing. And on the 0 end, you're going to be giving up probably making progress. You're going to be giving up being healthy. You're going to be giving up feeling good and feeling energized. But on the 10, the extreme level, you're going to be giving up likely social situations. You're going to be giving up having energy, like as well, both ends of the spectrum. You might not have as much energy as if you were like in the middle or a little bit to one end. And then you're also going to be giving up potentially like enjoyment of life. You might be giving up friendships, relationships. You might be giving up the important things in life in order to
to have that extreme goal in order to get very lean and be really, really strict with yourself. You might be giving up happiness on either end. So let's go through a little bit more of the spectrum here, because I want you guys to think about where you most relate in your current journey and potentially where might be a better spot for you. As we're going through number zero, and then we're just gonna go by twos, as we're going through, I want you to comment below which one you're at right now and which one you feel like you'd be better at, I think. Let's go from zero is absolutely no care about their health at all. And number two is probably like they try to eat healthy, or like they're aware that they should be eating healthy, but they don't necessarily always make those proper decisions. They still go out and drink on the weekends, and they still go get burgers and stuff like that, but maybe every once in a while they'll like make sure they get some vegetables in or whatever. Like they're still somewhat wanting to be healthy or wanting to try anyway, like the thoughts at least in their head, but they're not really there yet. Number four, I'd say, is like half unhealthy and half not. Like number four, five, and six are pretty much in the middle. Like I think number four is probably, I think I'd probably say number six is where I was in college, but number four is more like you're eating some meals of the day healthy and you're like, you're slightly aware, but you also don't really care if you go off on the weekends and enjoy a lot of food and enjoy alcohol and stuff like that, but you don't really care about making progress. You're just like, I'm gonna try to do this just because I think I'm supposed to kind of deal, but you might make progress sporadically if you're like a number four or number five. You might like look a little bit better, and you might sometimes like lose all that progress. You're probably that person that just maintains what they look like because you're not eating overly unhealthy or overly in a high amount of calories. And sometimes you are, but sometimes you're also under eating. So you're probably just like really, really maintaining and teeter tottering at like an unhealthy, not healthy level. But you're not necessarily that overweight, obese, chronically ill type of person as well. So I would say number six is where I was at in college, I think. In college, I was the kind of person that really wanted to make sure most of my meals of the day were healthy. So I would have egg white omelets and I would have salads, but then at the end of the night, I would have like cookies and ice cream, and then I would have like alcohol on the weekends and stuff, but I still really tried. And this is just in terms of like nutrition, guys. So I still really tried. I was on track probably 60% of the time, like more than 50, definitely, but not really past that. And my progress was happening, but it wasn't really happening. Like I didn't really see major changes until I turned myself into probably a 7 or an 8 or so. So I would say number 8 is something that like I'm at right now. I think I was more like a 7 this past week with tracking, but not really weighing much. I'm still like, I think number 7 is like where a good place for the large majority of people would be. I would recommend maybe like a 6 for most people, I think, who are watching this or at least interested in health and fitness, but maybe if you're not making progress, bump that up to a 7. I am currently like right around an 8, and when I'm home, I'm likely more around a 9. When I'm home and I'm in my routine, I'm usually tracking mostly everything, weighing out my food, making sure that things are on point, making sure that my micros are all getting in, stuff like that. But when I'm traveling, I'm probably closer to a 7 or 8 because I'm still tracking my food. I'm in a cut. I know that tracking for me is where it helps me kind of just be in control of my progress and not be like unaware of what's going on. I want to make sure that I'm still pretty much in control of my body. I was probably around the 7 or 8 because I was still tracking in the sense that I wasn't weighing, but I was entering what I was eating in my FitnessPal and just looking at it and estimating, because it's taken a few years for me to be able to do that. Just look at something and be like, that's probably 4 ounces of chicken, or that's probably 150 grams of potatoes. But I would say that that's where I was at this week, and I think that that's a really great place to be at. I think living in like a little bit more than health, but a little bit less than extreme tracking everything to the gram. I think I was probably like a 9.5 or so on prep. Like I was never like that, track my ketchup and every single vegetable and every single gram to the gram. Like I was never like, if I had 25 grams of protein to hit in terms of like what I was weighing on the scale, if I had 26, I wouldn't put 1 gram back or anything like that. But I was definitely a 10 or like an 11 even. But I am now the type of person that will just estimate like a salad and chicken and be like, that's probably right around there, like whatever. And I think that's a really great place to be at for most people. And for that purpose, you don't sacrifice too much progress, because where I am, I'm still wanting to make progress. Like I want to do it enough where I'm still making progress, but not really sacrificing too many social situations. Like obviously I had to sacrifice getting burgers and like having drinks and stuff like everybody else had this weekend, but I was still able to go and not feel super restricted and not feel super bad about what I was doing and choosing, and I was still able to at least get something. If you
identified with any one of these numbers, like zero, maybe you're like a one, or like a four, or like a seven, or nine, or 10, or whatever you at, make sure you write it down in the comment section, because I'm very, very, very interested in hearing where you guys are at, but also maybe like where you want to be, or where you think that you would thrive the most at. I think thriving for me is right around an 8, or an 8.5 or so, if I'm trying to cut and actually hit a goal, but if I'm trying to kind of just live, I think 6 or so. Let me know in the comment section if any of these connected to you. Give the video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, and I enjoyed it. And the next few vlogs you guys are gonna be seeing, maybe like the next one or two or so, are gonna be Brian and I's drive across the country. So I'm in Montreal right now. I'm headed to DC tonight. My flight takes off in about an hour, and I will see you guys on the expedition across the country. I'll catch you guys in the next video.